Hello everyone, this is the first video lecture on the course Nuclear Reactors. In this lecture, I will be discussing some of the basics of nuclear fission. Nuclear fission is a process in which a heavy compound nucleus splits up into nuclei of comparable masses. So that means if you bombard a heavy nucleus with a thermal neutron generally, then you will see that this nucleus splits up to produce two or more lighter elements of comparable masses. This was discovered by Otton and Stassmann in 1939. It is the best way to harness the nuclear energy. If you look at the history, in 1934, Enrico Fermi and his associates, they investigated a process, nuclear process called as neutron capture process, in which a neutron when bombarded with nucleus is captured by the nucleus and it will go to the excited state and it will come back to the ground state by emitting gamma photons, and this is called as N-gamma reaction. Their intention was to produce transuranic elements. That means when this uranium-238 is bombarded with neutron, they expected uranium isotope, that is uranium-239, which is highly unstable, which readily undergoes beta decay to produce neptunium, which in turn undergoes beta decay to produce plutonium. This was their expectation. But they failed to produce this process. And this work was later taken up by Hahn and Strassmann and other various groups. They noticed that the new elements which are formed during this process, they had some properties which were similar to the elements which are at the middle of the periodic table, just like the property shown by barium, property shown by strontium, antimony, etc. They called this new elements as barium-like, strontium-like nuclei. But later, when they carried out series of analysis, they noticed that these are actually barium and strontium. That means this heavy element uranium, when bombarded with neutron, that produces elements which are in the middle of the periodic table. So later, this process was named as fission. Meitner and Otto Frisch gave the correct explanation for this. They said, when this uranium is bombarded with a neutron, the heavy element, that is uranium, breaks up it into two or more lighter fragments, and this process is named as nuclear fission process. So this is the typical reaction that you can notice here. So you have uranium-92-235, which undergoes fission by a thermal neutron. Then you bombard it with a thermal neutron, you get a compound nucleus. So that is uranium-236, that is absorbed by uranium absorbs this neutron and forms a compound nucleus. And this compound nucleus immediately breaks up into barium and krypton, and in this process you get on an average say 2 to 3 neutrons are released, fresh neutrons are released. They are in fact fast neutrons. This is one way by which uranium undergoes fission. There are various modes by which uranium can undergo fission to produce different elements, but all these elements lies somewhere in the middle of the periodic table. One can estimate, you can calculate the amount of energy released in the fission process. Nuclear fission process is highly exergic reaction, that means it releases huge amount of energy. And the major portion of the energy is taken up by the kinetic energy of the fission fragments, that is about 167 MeV. And the kinetic energy of the prompt neutrons that is released in the process is about 5 MeV. and energy of prompt gamma rays is about 6 MeV, and energy of beta particles emitted in the fission fragments from the fission fragments is about 8 MeV. So this beta decay is associated with antineutrino emissions, and the energy carried by the antineutrinos is about 12 MeV, and the energy of gamma rays emitted from the fission fragments is about 6 MeV. If you add all these energies, it comes to be around 204 MeV. That means by the fission of uranium 235, so when one nuclei undergo fission, around 200 MeV of energy is released. So this is very huge amount of energy. Qualitatively, you can understand the fission by using what is called a specific binding energy curve. That means if you plot binding energy per nucleon on y-axis as a function of mass number for the elements in the periodic table, you get a graph like this. You can notice that most of this, the specific binding energy per nucleon increases and then almost saturates for most of the nucleus and slightly decreases towards the heavy nuclei. So the heavy nuclei like uranium, they possess binding energy per nucleon, specific binding energy about 7.6 MeV per nucleon. Whereas when this nucleus uranium undergoes fission, we get barium, krypton, etc., which lies in the middle of the periodic table, for which the specific binding energy is about 8.5 MeV. So therefore, the difference in the amount of energy, that is specific binding energy per nucleon, is about 0.9 MeV per nucleon. So when uranium-235 undergoes fission, we know that the mass number of uranium-235, so is 235. So 235 into 0.9, totally around 212 MeV, or approximately say 200 MeV of energy is released in the fission of uranium-235. So this is how you can understand the amount of energy release by the fission of one uranium nuclei qualitatively. Quantitatively also you can estimate the energy released in fission. This is a typical reaction. So uranium bombarded with neutron produces barium, krypton and three fresh neutrons. So one can use the mass difference to calculate the energy released. From the mass equivalent principle, we know that the masses of the reactants will be equal to the masses of the products minus the binding energy. So the energy released will be equal to binding mass defect into C square. So that is equivalent to binding energy. So that Q is equal to masses of the reactants minus masses of the products. So we have taken atomic masses here because the electron masses can be neglected. So the mass of uranium-235 is about 235.04278 atomic mass unit, and this is the mass of the neutron, this is mass of barium, and this is mass of kryptons, and this is mass of one neutron. We have three, we assume that say three neutrons are released in the process. So one can look at that, you know, you can estimate that from conservation of mass number. So there will be three neutrons emitted in this process. Totally, this value will be about 0.21537 atomic mass unit, and the energy equivalent to this atomic mass unit will be equal to 200.6 MeV. How do we get this? Because we know that one atomic mass unit is equal to 931 MeV. So if you multiply this by 931 MeV, you get around 200.6 MeV. Even quantitatively also we are getting the same result. That means around 200 MeV of energy is released per fission of uranium-235. This is a typical calculation. Just to understand the strength of energy released in a nuclear fission process. So this is a good example. Suppose say you have uranium-235. If you fission all uranium atoms in the given sample, say you have taken 1 gram of sample, If you take 1 kg of sample, the number of atoms and hence the number of nuclei in that sample will be around 2.564 into 10 power 24. How do you calculate this? So this is equal to Avogadro number divided by the mass number. So that gives 2.564 into 10 power 24. Hence the energy released per gram. So if you assume that all these nuclei undergoes fission, then energy released per gram of uranium-230. Per gram means you have to divide it by 10 power 3. This is for kg. Per gram you have to divide it by 10 power 3. So all this number of atoms, number of nuclei, that is 2.564 into 10 power 4, 24 divided by 10 power 3, and energy release per fission of one nucleus is 200.6 MeV. What is 1 MeV? 1 MeV is equal to 1.6 million means 10 power 6, EV means that is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 joules. 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 joules into 10 power 6, that is 1.6 into 10 power minus 13 joules. Totally, this will be 8.226 229 into 10 power 10 joules. The equivalent power calculation you can do, just divide it by time, then it will be about 2.29 into 10 power 4 kilowatt hour. Just look at the amount of energy. If you cause fission of 1 gram of sample, uranium sample, you get around 2.29 into 10 power 4 kilowatt hour of power. That means if you have a thermal power generator having capacity say 1 megawatt, then to produce this amount of energy, you have to run that thermal power plant for about a day. That is almost 22.9 hours is required to produce equivalent amount of energy. This is just generated by the fission of 1 gram of uranium. That shows the power of fission process. You can calculate this. You can also calculate how much coal is required in a thermal reactor to produce same amount of power. Generally, when you burn coal, so this is the process that takes place. Carbon combines with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide. When each carbon atom burns, that means when it becomes carbon dioxide, on an average you get around 4 EV of energy per atom of carbon. So therefore, energy released when 1 kg of carbon is burned completely will be equal to 4 into 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 EV, 19 joules, because for each carbon atom you get 4 EV of energy, and then the number of carbon atoms in 1 kg of sample is 6.025 into 10 power 23 into 10 power 3, because per gram it will be around 10 power 23. So if you convert it to kg, you have to multiply by 10 power 3. Divide by 12, carbon 12 it is, so divide by 12. So E will be about, energy will be 3.213 into 10 power 7 joules. The equivalent power will be 8.926 kilowatt hour. Therefore, the mass of carbon required to produce the amount of energy released in the fission of 1 gram of uranium. So already we have calculated this, the energy released in the fission of 1 gram of uranium-235 is 2.29 into 10 power 4 kilowatt hour. To produce the same amount of energy, the amount of carbon required, so that is coal required, is 2.29 into 10 power 4 divided by 8.926. So this power you have to divide, then you will see that it will be about 2.56 into 10 power 3 kg. That means about 2,500 kg of coal is required to produce the same amount of energy which 1 gram of uranium, if it undergoes fission, so it produces equal